हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम रीनी सूद, एन इंग्लिश टीचर फ्रॉम इंटरनेशनल पब्लिक सीनियर सेकेंडरी स्कूल संधू नगर लुधियाना. टुडे आई एक्सप्लेन चैप्टर 3 द शेफर्ड्स ट्रेजर फ्रॉम द बुक अ पैक्ट विद सन. इन अ विलेज इन ईरान देयर वंस लिव्ड अ शेफर्ड. ही वॉज वेरी पुअर. ही डिड नॉट हैव इवन अ स्मॉल कॉटेज ऑफ हिज ओन. He had never been to school or learnt to read and write, for there were very few schools in those days. Shepherd means person who takes care of the sheep. Cottage means a small house. A poor shepherd lived in Iran. He was so poor that he didn't even have a small house. Because of less number of schools during these days, he could never attend school to read and write. Though poor and uneducated, this shepherd was very wise. He understood people's sorrows and troubles and helped them face their problems with courage and common sense. Many people came to him for advice. Soon he became famous for his wisdom and friendly nature. The king of that country heard about him and thought of meeting him. Sorrow means unhappiness. Famous means well-known. In spite of his poverty and illiteracy, this shepherd was very wise. He was able to understand people's pains and often helped them to solve their issues with courage and wisdom. People used to visit him to find suggestions and solutions. Because of this ability, he became popular. His popularity reached the king as well and thought of meeting him. Disguised as shepherd and riding on a mule, one day the king came to the cave where the wise shepherd lived. As soon as the shepherd saw the traveler coming towards the cave, he rose to welcome him. He took the tired traveler inside the cave, gave him water to drink and a share of his own mere meal. The king rested for the night in the cave and was greatly impressed by the shepherd's hospitality and wise conversation. Wise means intelligent, mirj means ineducate. Dressed as a shepherd and hiding his true identity, the king reached the shepherd's cave on a mule. The moment the shepherd noticed him coming to his cave, he got up to greet him. He brought the traveler inside his cave and gave him water and food. The king took rest and stayed with him for the night in the cave. The king was impressed by his friendly, warm reception and words of wisdom. Though still tired, the king decided to depart the next morning. He said, "Many thanks for your kindness to a poor traveler. I have a long way to go. Permit me to leave." Looking straight into the eyes of his guest, the shepherd replied, "Thank you, Your Majesty, for paying me the compliment of a visit." Depart means leave. Permit means allow. Though the king was still feeling tired, yet he decided to leave from the place. The very next morning, he expressed his gratitude to the poor shepherd for his warm and kind welcome. He sought his permission to leave the place. The shepherd addressed the king as "Your Majesty," and looking straight into his eyes, expressed his gratitude. The king was astonished as well as pleased. "He is indeed very wise," he thought of himself. "I need people like him to work for me." And the king appointed this humble shepherd the governor of a small district. Although he rose to power and dignity, the shepherd remained as humble as ever. People loved and honored him for his wisdom, sympathy and goodness. He was kind and just to one and all. His fame as a fair and wise governor soon spread throughout the country. Sympathy means pity, goodness means virtue. The king was wondering and was full of joy to hear his words. He thought that the shepherd was actually very wise. The people liked him very much, and this was the need of the king. He must work for the king. The king made him the governor of a small district. In spite of all the power and dignity, the shepherd remained humble and modest. People liked him and were full of appreciation for his wisdom and kindness. His behavior was just to everyone. He became popular as a good and wise governor. Now, the governors of other provinces grew terribly jealous of him and began to talk to the king against him. They said, "He is very dishonest and keeps for himself part of money that he collects as tax from the people. Why did he always carry with him," they added, "an iron chest? Perhaps he carried in it the treasure that he had secretly collected. After all," they said mockingly, "he was an ordinary shepherd and could behave no better." Provinces means states. Mockingly means making fun of. The governor of other state developed jealousy for him. They started speaking against him to the king. They started calling him dishonest and blamed him for keeping part of the tax money with him. They even passed question over his iron chest. They said that it had all the treasures he had collected secretly. They made fun of him, calling him a common shepherd who was expected to behave in such a dishonest manner. At first, the king did not pay attention to these reports, but how long could he ignore these governors and their endless stories about the shepherd? One thing was certain, the king discovered the new governor did carry an iron chest with him all the time. Ignore means pay no attention, certain means sure. Initially, the king paid no attention to such words, but gradually he did not believe that the governor carried an iron chest with him. He thought that he must inquire about the reason for carrying an iron chest with him all the time. So one day, the new governor was summoned to the palace. He came riding on his camel, and to everyone's delight, the famous iron chest was there, fastened securely behind him on the camel's back. Famous means popularly, summoned means called for. Thus, the king called the new governor to the palace. He came on his camel. Everyone was feeling joy as the most talked about iron chest was tied behind him on the camel's back. Now the king was angry. He thundered, "Why do you always carry that iron chest with you? What does it contain?" Thundered means speak angrily. Seeing this, the king shouted in anger and asked him the reason for carrying that iron chest with him. The governor smiled. He asked his servant to bring the chest. How eagerly the people standing around waited for the shepherd to be found out. But how great was the astonishment, and even of the king himself, when the chest was opened, no gold or silver or jewels, but an old blanket was all that came out. Holding it up proudly, the shepherd said, This is my dear master, is my only treasure. I always carry it with me." Astonishment means surprise. Eager means curious. The governor smiled and asked his attendant to bring that chest. All the people were very curious to see and find what it had inside. But when it was opened, they found no precious gold or silver, but an old blanket. The shepherd took it in his hands with pride and explained to the king that it was his treasure. "But why do you carry such an ordinary blanket with you? Surely you are the governor of district," the king asked. To which the shepherd replied with quiet dignity, "This blanket is my oldest friend. It will still protect me if at any time your majesty should wish to take away my new clocks." Dignity means respectfully. Clocks means new clothing. But the king was curious to know the reason for carrying such an old blanket. To which the shepherd replied in a very dignified and respectful manner, that blanket was his oldest friend. In times of need, it would protect him. If the king wished, he could take his new clothing, but that blanket was very dear to him. How pleased the king was and was embarrassed. The jealous governors became to hear the wise man's reply. Now they knew that the shepherd was indeed the humblest and the wisest man in the land. The king made him the governor of a much bigger district that very day. Jealous means envious. The king felt very happy to hear his words. The governors were ashamed. Now it was clear to everyone that the shepherd was the humblest and the wisest man there. Feeling proud of him, the king gave him a bigger district to look after at that very time. So what we learn from this story is, one should be polite and humble. Have a nice time.